हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर विनय यादव, पीजी रेजिडेंट, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ रेडियो डायग्नोसिस, एबीवीएमएस एंड डॉक्टर आरएमएल हॉस्पिटल, न्यू दिल्ली। टाइटल ऑफ माय पेपर इज रोल ऑफ मल्टी डिटेक्टर कंप्यूटर टोमोग्राफी इन इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ कंजेनिटल साइनोटिक हार्ट डिजीज। इंट्रोडक्शन। कंजेनिटल हार्ट डिजीज आर कंसिडर्ड एज द मोस्ट कॉमन कंजेनिटल बर्थ डिफेक्ट्स, कंप्राइजिंग अराउंड 1% ऑफ ऑल लाइव बर्थ्स। CSDs have two types, asynotic and synotic, depending on the presence of cyanosis and physical examination. In cyanotic CSDs, systemic venous blood bypasses the pulmonary circulation and gets shunted into the left of the heart. MDCT can show the morphology of extracardiac vasculature, including the coronaries, pulmonary arteries, aorta, and pulmonary or systemic veins, and it delineates the vessel walls and also displays the airway mediastinal abnormalities and pulmonary parenchyma. Aim: to find out the role of MDCT in diagnosis of congenital cyanotic heart disease. Materials and method. Venue of studies: the study conducted in our department. Study type is cross-sectional observational study. Study duration is 1st January 2020 to 1st July 2021. Sample size is 60 cases. Inclusion criteria: patients of pediatric age group who have been clinically suspected to have cyanotic congenital heart disease were sent to our department and were included in the study. Methodology: MDCT on 128 slice semen somatome was done in all patients suspected to have cyanotic congenital heart disease based on clinically and preliminary examinations. Results: a total of 60 patients of cyanotic congenital heart disease were included in the study, out of which 20 patients were of TOF, 6 patients were of truncus arteriosus, 10 patients were of tricuspid atresia, 10 patients were of TGA, and 14 patients were of TAPVC. Now cases. First is TOF, tetralogy of Fallot. Here we can see a subaortic ventricular septal defect, and with more than 50% of overriding of aorta is also seen. And there is a severe infundibular and supravellular pulmonary stenosis is seen. Here right atrium is dilated and right ventricle is hypertrophic. We can also see a small MAPCAS, that is major aortopulmonary collateral arteries. Now second case is a TGA, transposition of great arteries. Here situs inversus is present because the stomach and the spleen on the right side and liver on the left side. And here morphological right atrium is on the left side and is joining the left ventricle, and the morphological left atrium is present on the right side and is joining the right ventricle. And aorta is seen arising from the right ventricle, and the pulmonary artery is seen arising from the left ventricle. So this is a transposition of great arteries. So by Van Praagh, this is congenital corrected TGA with situs inversus, mesocardia, and atrioventricular and ventriculo-arterial disconcordance. Now third case is tricuspid atresia. In this, the morphological right atrium is dilated and has no direct communication with the right ventricle. The right ventricular is hypoplastic and is associated with tricuspid atresia. Here we can also see ostium primum type of ASD with dilatation of the right atrium and the left ventricle. There is an aberrant right subclavian artery seen arising from the posterior aspect of arch of aorta and going posterior to esophagus. So by Van Praagh, it is situs solitus, levocardia, AV concordance, and D-loop ventricular topology. Now fourth case is truncus arteriosus with TOF. Here we can see a subaortic perimembranous VSD is seen with more than 50% overriding of aorta, and pulmonary valve is atresia is seen in this case, and the left pulmonary artery is seen arising from the lateral part of the truncus, and right pulmonary artery is hypoplastic, and so right lung is supplied by the collaterals formed by the bronchial artery. So this is a case of truncus arteriosus. By Van Praagh system, it comes in A3 classification. Fifth case is supracardiac TAPVC. In this, the right upper lobe and right lower lobe veins join to form a common channel superior to the left atrium. And the common channel is joined by another trunk formed by the left upper and left lower lobe pulmonary veins. And this combined to form a vertical vein. So vertical vein is seen to ascend anterior and to the left of the pulmonary artery along the mediastinal border to drain into the left brachiocephalic vein. In this case, the left brachiocephalic vein, the SVC, the right atrium, and the right ventricle are dilated. And large ostium secundum ASD is also seen. By Van Praagh system, it is SDS and AVVA concordance. Next case is cardiac TAPVC. In this, the SVC and IVC are draining into the right atrium, and the pulmonary veins are seen to drain into the coronary sinus and then into the right atrium. And so coronary sinus and right atrium are dilated, and we can also see a small muscular type of VSD is present. And by Van Praagh, it is situs solitus and levocardia, AVVA concordance and D-loop ventricular topology. Next is infracardiac TAPVC. In this, the pulmonary veins are converging behind the left atrium, and they are forming a common descending vertical vein, which is draining into the left pulmonary vein, portal vein. And the SVC and IVC are draining into the right atrium, and the ground glass opacities are seen in the bilateral lung fields due to the pulmonary edema along with the bilateral pleural effusion. And the situs is solitus and levocardia and AVVA concordance. Now discussion. Congenital heart disease are considered as the most common congenital birth defects, comprising around 1% of all live births. They have two types, asynotic and cyanotic. Among cyanotic, we have TGA, transposition of great arteries. In this, the complete transposition of great arteries occurs in the combination of atrioventricular concordance and ventriculoarterial disconcordance. That is, ascending aorta arises from the right ventricle and pulmonary artery arises from left ventricle. And in congenitally corrected TGA is a condition in which the both AV and VA disconcordance is present. Next is tricuspid atresia. In this, the morphological right atrium has no direct communication with the right ventricle, and there are two types. Most common is when the right atrioventricular connection is absent and areolar soft tissue occupies the gap. In rarer type, an atretic tricuspid valve is present. Third is TOF, tetralogy of Fallot. It consists of subpulmonary infundibular stenosis, overriding of aorta, ventricular septal defect, and right ventricular hypertrophy. Fourth is truncus arteriosus. In this, there is a single arterial trunk arises from the ventricles and through which a single arterial valve supply both the systemic pulmonary and coronary arterial circulation instead of separation of aorta and pulmonary artery. Fifth is TAPVC, total anomalous pulmonary venous connection. In this, it occurs when the pulmonary veins fail to drain into the left atrium normally and form an aberrant connection with some other cardiovascular structures. There are basically three types. Supracardiac TAPVC, in which pulmonary veins drain into vertical vein, which join left innominate vein and further join right innominate vein to form SVC and then drain into the right atrium. Cardiac TAPVC, in which the pulmonary veins are drained into the coronary sinus and into the right atrium. Infracardiac TAPVC, in which the pulmonary veins converge to form a vertical vein, which descends to enter into the portal vein, and it is always obstructive type due to vascular resistance of the liver. In conclusion, MDCT proved to be an important modality for decision making in patients with congenitally cyanotic heart disease. References. Thank you.